been making. Spinner baits and swim baits this week. And Coop, there's some of the new swim baits we made. He picked the gold fleck in there and we added that to the Sesquaw color. What do you want to try first?
I want to try that new fanfish you have with them.
Alright, there's a spinnerbait rod. We got, what, a chartreuse blade on that. Alright, on the spinnerbait. Swing him this way, buddy. Swing him into the boat. Alright, open your bail. Alright. Job. First fish on your spinner bait. Alright. So we got a first fish of the day on that chartreuse with the green head. Looks good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Alright, let's let him back in. Alright, put him back. Go hard! One took the 5-inch what's it in mama chalk color, but we got a different color to try, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
What's that one called, do you remember?
Gold.
No, that was the swim baits we made. We got one in Sesquaw, which is green with blue flake. All right we'll let this one go. Good job. Hey. Dude, you going snorkeling?
Yeah.
Can you catch me some hagramites?
No.
You don't know. Well, go get some. Keep reeling them. Swing them out. Pump it out that way. Keep reeling. Don't worry about the paddle. He's behind you. Now pump him up. He ran a long way with that, didn't he? Pump him up. Swing your rod tip this way, and then reel as you bring it back down to him. Pump him up, and then reel down. Pump him up, and then reel down. All right, now you can swing him my way. Nice catch, dude. Got him. All right.
Ouch.
Ouch, is he biting you?
No, he just claw me with his finger on his back.
All right, that's on the new Sesquaw. 5-inch, what's it?
Will
you
let him go?
Yeah, let him go. Get him, man. Reel him in. Pump the rod tip up. Oh, that's a good one. That's a big one, buddy. On the new color. Here, let me net him. Oh, goodness. Is he jumping? Swing him this way. He's 19 maybe. Oh, he's up in that grass. All right. Got a nice one on the new color. Give me 5, buddy. Let's see how big he is. He's 19. Nice 19 incher. You want your picture with him, buddy? Paul helped us take a couple pictures here. We're gonna go ahead and let him go. You wanna let him go, buddy? Yeah. Bye bye, fishy. That's 19 incher.
He's gonna
hang out right in that grass. It's just our 5-inch wetsuit.
Okay.
On the 8-ounce dragon head. I got a pile of them here. I had extra because I was making the craws. And I said, you know what? I'm gonna shoot a bunch of them here. So give them a try. Thanks. You got 8-ounce dragon heads?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And then just letting it sit. That's how you do, mainly.
Pump it up and then reel down to it. Twist him back. All right. Swing the rod tip up my way. Now reel down. Reel down. He's coming about. He's coming about.
Fish are hard to reel in.
Keep reeling. Lift him up. Rod tip up.
Rod angle.
Lift the rod tip up, buddy. Pump him up. Alright. Let's see what we got here. He's a nice one. He's a nice one. Alright. You want to lip him?
Okay.
Stick your thumb in there. Get him. Pick him up. Lift him up. Good boy. Lift him up. There you go, Coop. What do you think of him?
He looks nice.
Yeah. How big is he? Here, hold his tail there. Hold his tail right on the zero. All right. Swing it to the zero. Swing it up. And he's... about 18.
Wow, that's big for fish.
Another nice 18 incher on the Susquehanna, the 5-inch what's it? Go ahead and put him back.
I'm going off his belly.
Yeah, put him back. Boom. Bye bye. There he goes. Let me see what you got. All right, nice. What is he? 18 or so? He's a nice one.
Yeah.
Nice job. Here, hold on to your fish.
Him,
he was on the Capurple?
Capurple wants it, yeah.
Nice.
Can I pull him, Brent?
Catch, buddy.
Thanks.
What were you doing with it?
I threw it up above this moving water and I just let it drift down into the slower bubbles right there in the center.
So it was just tumbling on a dragon?
Yeah, and it kind of went over a ledge and then I felt one solid thump and then the line just went tight and I set the hook in.
Very cool.
He took off. He really inhaled it.
Sweet. Hi, fishy. Alright, let him go. Yeah. Oh, that's a good jump.
Yeah. I'm trying him to do it again.
No, you don't want him to jump. That's when they get off, is when they jump. You want me to net him?
Yeah.
I don't think we're ready for him. Keep him on that side. Oh. Tip up. Oh, 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 okay. And open the bail. It's a long way for you to reach, isn't it? Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, we got him. Another one?
Is it fun, Daddy, when you catch fish?
Yeah. You think so? Mm-hmm. All right, I have fun. Here, you get him. Grab him. Put him back. Ka-dong. Bye-bye. See that? All right, buddy. Last one of the day. You gonna put him back?
Yes.
Flip him. Say, see you when you're bigger.
See you when you're bigger.
Right on. All right, you ready to zoom?
Yeah.
Something river fishermen need to take into account while they fish in the summer is the effect that thunderstorms can have on the relative water clarity. And what's common in the summer is for there not to be a significant rise, but there to be a good amount of sediment stirred up in the river from a thunderstorm. And what you'll get is, you know, with the river flowing down this way, you'll get from one tributary that got a lot of thunderstorms, you'll have a lane of mud rolling down one side of the river. And as it moves downstream, that band gets wider and wider until the whole thing is muddy. What you can do is move to the, you know, to the other side, and you have a different tributary. And this happened to me in different rivers over the summer. One was on the Rapidan and Rappahannock River in central Virginia. It also happens on the Susquehanna, where you have a river that's a mile wide, where you have one branch that is green water coming down. And then you can have another tributary, it's completely clear. So you can either move into that clear lane and fish this area, or you can stay in the stained water. But what you need to focus on are how you make your presentations, what type of baits that are gonna work best in the different clarity. And generally, you're gonna do more of your finesse presentations, and we've done really well with the dead stick 5-inch What's It by Confidence baits, just dead sticking those. And then once we're into the muddier water, you know, we've caught fish on spinner baits and even hard jerk baits, rattle traps, things like that. But unless there's a really good rise, it doesn't really affect where they position in the river. And it's pretty consistent. Late summer, it's all about the taper ups. You know, fairly stable river levels. If there's a rise, you know, it has to be a pretty significant rise to push them to the bank. And here's our flow going this way. And a lot of guys are going to target the riffles, the areas right below where there's a little riffle or a ledge drop or something like that. And that's a great spot for catching numbers of fish. And it's a great spot for catching big fish if you have low light conditions. Early and late in the day, the big fish will visit here and feed fairly heavily. But throughout the day, you're going to look for taper ups, and you're basically going to go to the last little bit of a pool before it ends, and they'll be up in 2 feet or less of water with a high volume of water out in front of them. So basically, where it gets really skinny right before it goes into the next riffle, that taper up where, you know, there's a big deep water area out in front of them. I think it gives them a nice view of the entire pool. That is an A-plus spot. Another good spot, what I'd rate as a B spot, is a mid-pool boulder in deep water. But again, you're gonna catch these fish in the clear water by doing finesse presentations. And if it's muddy water, they're going to be in these same spots with the same sort of relative values. You're just going to have to present something that's a little bit louder, a little bit flashier, that'll get noticed in that turbid water from the thunderstorm.
Have you learned something from this video? There's a whole lot more to learn with my DVD series available at kayakfishinggear.com and confidencebaits.net. Order your DVD combo pack today.